Judicial Watch, IRS docs reveal McCain's subcommittee staff director urged IRS to engage in financially ruinous, quote, targeting of nonprofits, by Christina Layla for the GatewayPundit.com. Conservative watchdog group Judicial Watch obtained IRS documents Thursday revealing Senator John McCain's former staff director urged the IRS, including the corrupt Lois Lerner, to engage in financially ruinous targeting of nonprofit organizations. Via Judicial Watch, Judicial Watch today released newly obtained internal IRS documents, including material revealing that Senator John McCain's former staff director and chief counsel of the Senate Homeland Security Permanent Subcommittee, Henry Koerner, urged top IRS officials, including then director of exempt organizations, Lois Lerner, to audit so many that it becomes financially ruinous. Koerner was appointed by President Trump as special counsel for the United States Office of Special Counsel. The explosive exchange was contained in notes taken by IRS employees at an April 30, 2013 meeting between Koerner, Lerner, and other high-ranking IRS officials. Just 10 days following the meeting, former IRS Director of Exempt Organizations, Lois Lerner, admitted that the IRS had a policy of improperly and deliberately delaying applications for tax-exempt status from conservative nonprofit groups. Lerner and other IRS officials met with select top staffers from the Senate Government Affairs Committee in a marathon meeting to discuss concerns raised by both Senator Carl Levin and Senator John McCain, and that the IRS was not reining in political advocacy groups in response to the Supreme Court's Citizens United decision. Senator McCain had been the chief sponsor of the McCain-Feingold Act and called the Citizens United decision, which overturned portions of the act, one of the worst decisions I have ever seen. In the full notes of an April 30th meeting, McCain's high-ranking staffer, Koerner, recommends harassing nonprofit groups until they are unable to continue operating. Koerner tells Lerner Steve Miller, then chief of staff to IRS Commissioner Nicole Flax and other IRS officials, maybe the solution is to audit so many that it is financially ruinous. In response, Lerner responded that it is her job to oversee it all. Henry Koerner asked how to get to the abuse of organizations claiming Section 501c4, but designed to be primarily political. Lois Lerner said the system works, but not in real time. Henry Koerner noted that these organizations don't disclose donors. Lois Lerner said that if they don't meet the requirements, we can come in and revoke, but it doesn't happen timely. Nan Mark said if the concern is that organizations engaging in this activity don't disclose donors, then the system doesn't work. Henry Koerner said that maybe the solution is to audit so many that it is financially ruinous. Nicole noted that we have budget constraints. Elise Bean suggested using the list of organizations that made independent expenditures. Lois Lerner said that it is her job to oversee it all, not just political campaign activity. President of Judicial Watch, Tom Fitton, had this to say about the newly obtained IRS documents, showing more proof the agency was weaponized under Obama. The Obama IRS scandal is bipartisan. McCain and Democrats who wanted to regulate political speech lost at the Supreme Court, so they sought to use the IRS to harass innocent Americans. The Obama IRS scandal is not over, as Judicial Watch continues to uncover smoking gun documents that raise questions about how the Obama administration weaponized the IRS, the FEC, FBI, and DOJ to target the First Amendment rights of Americans. You can support Judicial Watch here. Tom Fitton, the Obama IRS scandal is now over as Judicial Watch continues to uncover smoking gun documents that raise questions about how the Obama administration weaponized the IRS, the FEC, FBI, and DOJ to target the First Amendment rights of Americans. So, McCain, you're a traitor, just like we always knew you were a traitor. But what were these people working for? They most likely are basically I would say Catholic, wouldn't they be? So they're fighting against their own people. Like, so which faith do you believe in, McCain, if you're willing to do this? I mean, does it make any sense to why? Because these Lois Lerner looks white to me, or whatever, in McCain. So who are they fighting for? Against their own, and allowing Obama to weaponize everything against every American right? I mean, the freedom of speech, that's what they were trying to shut down. That's why Obama gave the internet away. That's why now with the EU, they're censoring the internet. I mean, basically, that's what they want to do. It didn't go through yet, but they all voted for it. Now it has to go through another section, parliament or something, to get through. I mean, it is disgraceful. Listen, folks, this is the fight for our way of life that basically we have never seen after the mess that Obama created and the rest of the evil people in Europe, in the EU, that, you know, that's the one world government. They want no freedom of speech, no anything, only what they want to be heard and nothing else. And McCain is a disgrace, a disgrace. And I think you know, he couldn't leave this earth soon enough for my liking. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.